Nepal is just one of the richest country in terms of water resources, but we have a huge problem to get the safe water. Every year, when monsoon comes and if there is flood happens, then there is sure epidemic will happen in country. And every year we have such kind of news.
I realized that the basic issues for the poverty and for the development of Nepal is the water.
So we need to think globally as a youth, but need to act locally, and we need to practice what we know.
Life is a struggle. In life, there must be a dream. Dream of doing something good.
I'm Furba. Furba Sange Moktan. Paschim Paaila is a bigger movement. It's a youth movement. This movement includes the dedicated for the healthy communities and the healthy society. It was kicked off in Nepal when there was a big epidemic of cholera in the western part of Nepal, which is very remote itself. Around 100 youths, dedicated youths combined together, and they made a plan and they encountered for the cholera. They rescued and they share the knowledge, they aware, they educate, and even they intervene from the health professionals, doctors, public health, friends, students.
My name is Kamala Kesi, and before in Paschim Paaila, I was there in executive board. And the youth campaign was started as a youth, Paschim Paaila Youth Against Diarrhea. It was started with campaign. And after finishing that campaign, some of the youths like me and Furwa and Giri, like others are, think that we can't stop it in only in campaign. After that, we established Paschim Paaila as a youth network, especially working in the sector of WAS, disaster and epidemic. And later then, I coordinate a project, WAS-led youth empowerment project as a project assistant. We choose two community, one Pathiwara community and another is Jasol community in Lalitpur. And initially, from planning phase to implementation phase and closing phase, I was there in Pathiwara.
I'm from Solukhumbu. Now I'm living in Kathmandu, Kopon, Pathiwara. This Pathiwara place is very good place where neighbors are very friendly, and in the surrounding there are school, colleges, medical hospitals, everything, every facilities over here is very good. This is my bedroom where I used to sleep, and this is our small table style where my mom used to pray. This is our toilet plus dishwashing place, and this is our roof, which is sloped downly towards down area, so to collect the rainwater from which comes from sky, and we collect the rainwater in our bowl, and it's very pure to wash dishes, to wash clothes, and if the water comes clean, then we use it to drink also.
First thing is about the water. The water of our community is not so healthy, and it's the environment of Kathmandu is unhealthy environment. There is so much sound pollution, the wastage and garbage are surrounded everywhere, and the rivers are very polluted.
We are now in middle of the Dobikola River and the Pathiwara Toll. I think this river making them easy in their life rather than facing more problem because they dispose the drainage system direct to the river, and also they throw the solid waste direct to the river. I think people have no other choice rather than this. If they make a safety tank and something like that, but they don't have any enough area for the safety tank. The problem is that the drainage system is also direct to the river, and they use near to the river. They dig the well and they dig. They're taking water. That's why the cross contamination is high in this issue.
Another most challenges at that time what we see was the water, drinking water. They used to drink water from groundwater, but the groundwater is highly polluted in Kathmandu, mostly with iron and ammonia and E. coli.
Actually, we are now in front of the public toilet. Though this is not in functioning, but people are still using this toilet. So it is necessary to maintain the community toilets rather than giving them a pan or something like that, because they don't have any space. That's why they are unable to make the toilet. We just analyzed the situation here, and we felt the need that we need to provide some drinking water for the children. That's why we support here. This is a biosand filter. We install it, and in biosand filter we distribute water from rainwater harvesting, as well as here is a deep boring system here, and from deep boring water is came up to this biosand filter, and after filtering the water from biosand filter, we collect the water in this tank, and students are able to drink the water. Nowadays, I am working in an info word center as a word center trainer. Behavior change, first stage is knowledge, and people need to aware. If people are not aware, how they can change their behavior?
For example, if you implement WASH project in one area without knowing importance of that thing, then that project won't be sustainable. The first big challenge is unstable political scenario of Nepal. And another one is lack of education. Many donors comes in Nepal and build like a huge structure and pipe water supply system, but they do not look after the quality of the system. And there is no ownership of community.
In case of Pathivara, most of the people are suffering from those diseases, but they don't know what the cause of those diseases. When we teach them about the causes, and they really feel, yes, this is the cause of hand washing, poor sanitation, and the impure water, unsafe water is the cause of those diseases. That's why we need to cut off it through the into the root. That's why we focus more on software part rather than hardware part.
Now I am involved in a club whose name is Pathivara Nava Yuva Club, and it is the club which was established for sports purposes. Previously there our brothers used to play, they are very crazy about the sports, and slowly this club work in other sectors also, like in cleanliness, sanitation and other things. I always remember one thing, that leadership is action, not a position. Now I'm 19 years old. I'm as a part of family member, I'm the son, I'm the elder son of this family, so I have some responsibility towards my family also. When I was childhood, then they can take care of me, they can love me, then now I think it's my time to love them and take care of them, and take care of not only of them, it's time to take care of the whole community by doing some good things around here. Yeah, I met Kamala Di in Boisungana, and she was very friendly. And Paschim Paaila were in source of the community, which they can give some trainings. After learning about the WAS, I held a program of cleaning our surrounding ourselves. And we are gathering our child group here, our Pathivara Juniors Club members, and we are gathering there, and we are separating them in five groups. And in group there are three members. One, each person have their own duty, their own responsibility. One is sweeping, and another one is collecting the garbages, and last one is disposing the garbages in a one place. And like this, we are doing our work, and now our brothers are cleaning the surrounding. And in 2 weeks, we used to clean our surrounding like this.
So I highly acknowledge the club. There are so many members, president, vice president, so many members, and they are very active in their own work, and among them Santosh is one key person for this community, and he helped us a lot while we are working here.
Youth is the one important group who can grab the knowledge easily, and not only grabbing the knowledge, they can implement that so easily. I think due to their enthusiasm, willingness to learn new things, and willingness to do something new in their society, so youth is a very important group.
Thank you. This is my kitcha. This is my kitcha.
It is not possible to bring so many changes in 1 year. the people are still using to throw their garbage into directly into the river because they don't have any option. So this is the beginning. If we educate youth more, we build the capacity of youth more, then they can they bring the change in their community.
So for this cause, for the healthy Nepal, for epidemic free Nepal, I am activist. So I am a campaigner. It's because whatever there is a project or not, but the, my personal concern and my our youth's concern is always there to make Nepal a epidemic free Nepal.
Really, nowadays I feel that yes, I am a youth activist. I need to do so many things in this sector, and also we need to influence other youth to work in this sector.
Youth are the power of the nations, and if they can, they want something, they have desire to do anything, then they can do that.
Why not youth? So we always, sometimes we ask that why youths get involved, should involve. So why not youths? It's because they are the energetic mass of the nation.
People used to say that youths are the leaders of tomorrow's leaders, but we used to say that no, youths are the today's leader. So youths need to do so many things. And in Nepal, 1/4 of the youth population are covered by youths.
And even lots of revolutions, lots of changes have occurred just because the awareness raised on the youth.
So the huge mass of youth can really bring a change in the society.
Being a youth, you have to feel very proud. In this time period, we have to do something good which can establish us as a good person in the whole community, whole nation. So
change is started with one person. So I changed, my friends changed, then one community changed, then nation changed, then the world became changed. So the change is started with one person. So let's start individually.